Epidemiological models are very good at measuring mortality because that's fairly cut and dried. They're less good at measuring the subjective experience of, for instance, social distancing and lockdown. So what the costs are to people of having to change their behaviour radically. So we know that vulnerable groups will benefit from not coming into contact with the virus, but we don't measure the costs of loneliness very well, for instance. So if you have to choose between getting coronavirus or never meeting another human being for the next 6 weeks, you know, that's a real choice in some ways, but it's presented as though there's no choice. There's the interesting way in which home has become a place to which many people are confined, and of course for people for whom home is not a safe place, then a lockdown and social distancing brings all sorts of dangers if, for instance, you've got violence in your intimate or domestic relations. If you're a sex worker and your home is also your place of work and you're not allowed to bring people into it anymore, then there's risks of poverty and marginalisation that go along with a lockdown that's meant to be saving your life. One interesting emergent feature of the current pandemic is that certain ethnic groups seem to be more susceptible. And we're seeing that in healthcare professionals, and we're also seeing that in social care settings. There's a tendency to assume immediately that it's some deficit of the ethnic minority concerned. So there's been a rush to produce, for instance, hand washing information in different languages. But another theory is that actually, because, for instance, social care is a low status, low paid job, it's often overrepresented with people who are of migrant background or migrants themselves. These are people who can't afford not to show up at work and are therefore maybe being exposed to the virus in greater measure than those of us who can work at home. By the time a pandemic hits, it's kind of too late, because that's when all the weaknesses in the system play out. And actually what we all ought to be doing is preparing for the next pandemic. Because in order to do that, we need to ensure that we have healthcare systems that are equal and that are based on principles of social solidarity.